Hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to CG Films. It's currently 9:35 in the morning, and I've just been to town. And today could be opening as Resident Evil 2. But despite turning Guinness and Smiths, because I actually got this with the £5 offer, knowing me. But I just thought I'd quickly mention, if you want to get a bit cheaper, because you know it's around £40, this game is, and you can kind of get for like £37 in Argos. From what I've heard. But on that though, I thought I'd get the game either way. But a bit of a brief history of Resident Evil with myself, because I never actually played the original games, even though I did watch my friend play the original game back on the, weather days when the games came out. But either way, despite that, I never played the original games because I actually got into Resident Evil because of Resident Evil 5 and return regards on the action-based games. But since it's gone back to survival horror, with Resident Evil 7 and whatnot, it's nice that Capcom in general gone back to survival horror roots despite in this game in general, because it combines the original, Resident Evil 2 game, and then it is the like third person perspective, which is good that they did that because I actually preferred that than many other users from Resident Evil 4, and also utilizing the engine from Resident Evil 7, and combine all together to have this nice nostalgia modern and take of Resident Evil 2, which I'm looking forward to because I did enjoy the demo, and regardless, I did it around 20 odd minutes from the demo, but I did enjoy it though. I'm looking forward to trying this game even with the demo that I enjoy, but I hope it's not saying too hard. There is some difficulty for those hardcore fans who are looking forward to this, and I hope you enjoy it either way. But yeah, I thought I'd get the game nonetheless, and I'm just looking forward to playing it either way. So here we got ourselves a nice box art, and with good old Leon Kennedy and Claire Redfield. I hope I pronounced their names right. I'm not very good when it comes to Resident Evil characters, but yeah, either way, with the here's the side, here's the back, told you more about the game. But yeah, I just never actually played the original Resident Evil 2, despite I did enjoy the demo, but I'll try out the game at least. The install size, I've heard it should be 21, but either way, I just hope this game, I enjoyed this game, because usually I don't play much Resident Evil games. I've played most of the action-based games, like I said, but I hope the survival horror aspects don't be like, oh, now we're running out of ammo and all that. Anyways, let me just get the stabby knife. Ah, it's broken! Because they added a mechanic with a knife, so you don't have like an infinite knife. They are quite low on a certain weapon base, and once it breaks kind of thing, you know what I mean, for a certain game. Anywho, quick with jibber jabber, let's open this. Get the stabby knife. Take off the shrink wrap. But yeah, I bet you I'm going to jump scare quite a bit in this game. Regards, I'm looking forward to doing a stream of this tomorrow on Saturday. When I do some, streaming on Twitch, I should say. There we go. Right, get this out. There we go. And we open it up and see what content we have inside. Basically nothing. Nothing at all. But I heard basically if you buy the deluxe edition, you get like loads of extra bits, and it's actually £12 on Xbox Live, I should say, if you want to get all the extra stuff that you want to. But I actually got just the standard edition, regardless, taking advantage of a £5 off offer either way from Smiths, knowing me. Anyways, we'll leave that with the opening. I know you'll really enjoy it, and I'll leave with some gameplay. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.
Still alive.